America's happiest companies, Melissa, have just been revealed. This is another list. We brought you another one yesterday. Here's what this one says. For the second straight year, Pfizer, the pharmaceutical giant, is number one, followed by Kaiser Permanente, Texas Instruments, EMC Corporation, and Qualcomm. Employees who participated in the Career Bliss survey were asked about their work-life balance, the relationship they have with their boss and their coworkers, job resources, salary, growth opportunities, company culture and reputation, as well as their daily tasks. Local business owner and lead faculty for the Goldman Sachs Small Businesses Program, Ibrahim Firat, is here in the studio to discuss what he feels it takes to make a happy work environment. Ibrahim, thank you for coming in first
off. Thanks for reminding me.
So a lot of times people think, well, I'll be happy if I have a lot of money. And salary is on the list in terms of what makes people happy, but it's not necessarily the most important, right?
That is correct. In fact, it's number one that tops the list is respect. Respect to employees and have them treated as human beings.
Well, nobody wants to be walked all over, and people want to feel like that. Hey, I'm spending a lot of my time here away from my family, and you should respect what I'm doing here.
In fact, they spend more time at work than they do with their family.
But don't you show respect in business by giving a person a hefty salary or at least a fair salary?
You do. You do. So it's not to say that we should discount compensation, but it's more about the work-life balance. It's more about the growth, the teaching, and the fact that you're part of a family at the work environment as well as you're in the home environment.
From a business standpoint, it's important, isn't it, to get the employees out of the everyday work routine because that can become monotonous. You know, Google is notorious for that. You know, they do like exercise classes and you know, we see these stories where people go out to luncheons and they have dance parties.
Talk about that. I mean, you can you know, in fact, many small businesses be able to do this. They just do surprise parties, surprise bowling parties that they take their employees to just to just take you out of that zone and be really part of a community. That's the really what they
and
want.
Ultimately,
to
that builds morale, and they're thinking, okay, if you've got a happy employee, they're going to be more productive.
That's exactly right. That's the Hawthorne effect. That's it.
Okay, let's see. I'm looking at the list. You're listening to employees. People want to know that their ideas not just kind of go over the boss's head. They want to know that they're actually being listened to.
Absolutely. In fact, if you look at a survey done for small businesses, many of the innovative ideas that small businesses implement today are given to them as advice by their employees. So if you listen to them, you're going to be more productive. You're going to grow your revenues. And in turn, you get more productivity from your employees.
Another big one is having a flexible schedule because there are so many households these days where there is both the mother and the father working.
Absolutely.
And you want to spend, you know, you're torn between work and you're torn between family.
Absolutely.
And you kind of want to have the best of both worlds. So offering that flexible schedule is key.
Absolutely. And in fact, many people would prefer like a 4-day schedule now, like 10 hours each. And they'd like to have a 3-day weekend. And you know what? If you can offer them that, that's
I was gonna say, can you talk to my boss after this segment? At the same time, we're coming out of the tough economy from 2008, really the last 5 or 6 years. Isn't it safe to say that there are some businesses out there who think that they don't necessarily have to treat their employees as well because, hey, you're just lucky to have a job. They sell that, and because there's a lot of people that want your job.
And that is true, but it's dying out more and more because they realize, businesses realize that employees are the center of the business. So there are certain things that make a company productive. And in fact, number one is the employees. So if you keep them happy and not so much stressed out, they tend to give you 100%, 110%.
Finally, we just have about 10 or 15 seconds left. Would you encourage an employee who say is unhappy at work to address it with their bosses and say, hey, listen, how do you do that without being like, hey, I'm unhappy and I'm a ho-hum, I'm not a good employee?
Here's the thing, it depends on the company culture. If there is open channels of communication in the company, you can make that happen and you're encouraged to do so.
Great insight, Ibrahim Firat. We appreciate you stopping by.
Appreciate it. Thank you, Chris.
Thank you, sir.
Appreciate it.